Smart Culture, Mathematics.
The word calculus actually comes from the Latin meaning small stone, because it is like understanding something by looking at small, tiny pieces. Differential calculus cuts something into small pieces to determine how it changes, while integral calculus joins or integrates the small pieces together to find how much there is. Take a look at this picture. Let's say this is an athlete, Usain Bolt. How fast is he going right now? Not just his average speed or his speed for the last second or his average speed over the next 5 seconds. I want to know how fast is he going right now. This is where differential calculus comes in. It refers to the instantaneous rate of change. It is all about what is happening right now in this instant. Now, you might wonder why we cannot use traditional algebra to solve this problem of how fast Usain Bolt is going right now. Well, how about we take a look at this graph? Now, remember, this athlete Usain is able to travel 100 meters in 9.58 seconds. So here we have the graph. Since we have the time and the distance, we can determine his average speed. And average speed is equal to the change in distance over the change in time. This equals 100 meters over 9.58 seconds. So the answer will be equal to 10.4 meters per second. So his average speed is then 10.4 meters per second. One very important thing to keep in mind is that average speed is not the same as instantaneous speed. When the gun fires, Usain will obviously not be running 10.4 meters per second immediately and all the way, because 10.4 meters per second is just his average speed. At first, when the gun fires, he's going to start a little bit slower and then accelerate. This means that the slope here in the beginning is going to be a bit slower than the average slope. Then he's going to start accelerating and the slope will get steeper and steeper. Let's say when Usain is close to the finish line, he starts tiring off a bit. The distance that he traveled, plotted against time, in reality, might be a curve similar to this. So by using the formula of average speed, where you have to divide the change in distance over the change in time, we calculate the average slope across the change in time. But if you take a look at this graph, you'll notice that we could see at any given moment in time, the slope is different. Take a look at the beginning. He has a slower rate of change of distance. When he accelerates here in the middle of the graph, it seems like his rate of change of distance, in other words, the tangent line at that point, it looks a lot higher than his average. Now, when he's approaching the finish line, he starts to slow down again. Even with all these changes, the average speed remains 10.4 meters per second. If you do some research, you'll see that Usain's instantaneous velocity or speed is actually closer to 12.28 meters per second. That means his fastest point in the 9.58 seconds is actually closer to 12.28 meters per second. You can try to approximate the slope right here. Let's get the change in x and the change in y and divide it. You can do this, but still, it will only be an approximation since the slope of this curve is constantly changing. So what you have to do is you have to see what happens as the change of x gets smaller and smaller and smaller, because then your approximation will become better and better and better. So actually, you have to take the limit as delta x approaches zero of your change in y over your change in x. When you do this, you're actually approaching the instantaneous rate of change, the instantaneous slope at a specific point in a curve, or alternatively, the slope of the tangent line at that point in the curve. In calculus, this is known as the derivative. The instantaneous slope is the derivative. The notation we use for the derivative is dy over dx. Dy is a differential and dx is a differential as well. Take one last look at this formula. It actually refers to an infinitely small change in y over an infinitely small change in x. So by using this formula, you'll actually be able to determine the instantaneous slope, the instantaneous speed in this case, which is the speed of Usain Bolt right now.
For online tutoring or additional resources, visit our website, www.smartculture-education.com.
Subscribe down below. It's easy.